I'm Nigel Bell, eco-design architects. I've been working in the mountains for most of my adult life, doing environmental homes in an environmentally precious place where bushfire absolutely is part of the fundamental fabric of this area. The Blue Mountains has about twice the ratio of properties that are officially bushfire affected than anywhere else. ...74% of Blue Mountains properties are technically affected to a smaller or greater extent. How do you deal with the inevitable consequence of bushfire sweeping through one of the most bushfire-prone areas in the world? The nature of bushfire, it's very sporadic. It can jump. The number one issue is burning embers, which can fly kilometres ahead or separately from the fire front. If you've got the bushland really close or you're building above a slope, then you'll get direct flame contact, all of which makes it harder and harder and harder to have a completely safe home, but you can certainly do a whole number of things to make the risk less and less. You look at non-combustible construction on the outside. You look at the weak points, which might be gaps and cracks around windows and doors, and you look at whether you need to put stainless steel shutters to protect those vulnerable areas. And certainly, you don't have timber decks or timbers up high where they will very readily ignite in a hot bushfire. When I'm looking at a new site, I look immediately at what are the natural site features. I look at the slope of the land. I look at where there's any benching, any flat areas. I look at the nature of the trees. Are they tall, which would indicate deeper soil, or are they shorter, which indicates shallower soil? If you are going to build in bushland, one of the safe ways to do it, depending on the slope, is to build into the slope. So the house that we've looked at was carved out back into the slope. They put in a concrete frame and a huge concrete roof to carry the weight of half a metre of wet soil and plants, and then waterproofed the roof, and then of course put the earth back and have developed a very special lovely garden on the roof. So you actually live underneath. You do a whole series of things depending on the risk and the regulations to make sure that when you're building, you're actually doing it as safe as is reasonable and as much as people can afford. It's a risk building or living wherever you are. Obviously, it comes back to how significant a risk it actually is. And the answer is, if you build in the right place, build sensibly, the risk is low. You probably have more risk driving on the roads than you do being swept up by a bushfire.